Well, welcome back, blade fans. Got a new knife company today. I was contacted by David Chen, a prolific designer for Petrified Fish, the 818, as well as SIMU. No. You know, I kind of can see the name, but anyway, David reached out to me on Instagram and wanted to know if I wanted to review a knife from a relatively new knife company, at least new to me, that he is designing for, or he could have some affiliation with. I'm not really clear on that. Took a few weeks and finally arrived today. So I figured, hey, what the heck? We'll take a look at it. And this is from a company right here, Wepe. I believe that's how you pronounce it, Wepe knife, and made in Yangjiang, China, which is kind of the knife making capital of China, where we see many companies headquartered. There's the box. Not much to it, really. And so this is the 737, I believe, kind of like the old airplane, Boeing 737. That's how I remember things, mnemology. There is David's signature on the clip. It's kind of a polished clip. Does have the nubby screws there. They're not flat, and that does not transfer over to the left side of the knife, unfortunately. Has a lanyard slot. And it's made from this particular one from Green G10, pretty heavily textured. Got a nice design milled in there. And we're gonna take a look at the blade, which if you know the Petrified Fish 818, you'll recognize immediately as a virtual clone of that, except that this is a much heavier duty version of that knife and larger. And so, there is the name. It's referred to as the Camping Friend, the WP737 in D2, our old friend D2. Pretty nice thick blade stock. Got this interesting swedge back here. Got some nice jimping. Very grabby jimping, a short run of about a half inch maybe. Comfortable in the hand. Flat, good size handle, plenty of it. Nice satin finish on this one. And above everything else, this is only going for, I think, $26 to $29 is what I'm seeing on the Wepe website. I'll leave you the links. Got the W there for the company name and what appears to be a T8 for the pivot. Interestingly enough, got kind of like a triple screw combination here where the clip is, and then we got a screw underneath holding the backspacer in, and another one there. So two screws holding the what looks like a black G10 backspacer that's got its own grippy sort of jimping on it. It's a comfortable knife to hold, and I could see how this could be a camping sort of a knife. Also, by the way, has a point straight on line, very spear point sort of profile. We'll measure it up. What do you say? So overall, it is big. It is 8¾ inches. Let's see if I can back out just a bit. Can I? Yep. And right there. I'm fussy about the background. What can I tell you? Wizard of Oz kind of thing. I want to see the man behind the curtain. 8¾ and 3¾ blade length with 3¾ cutting edge. So a lot of effective real estate there. In inches, the handle thickness is 0.53. And the blade stock, that's probably the thickest right there, is a 0.14, which is 3.6 millimeters. It is not a light knife. I'm suspecting this will be a little on the heavy side. Feels a little handle heavy. but perceptions aren't always realities. 4.57, we'll call that. So a bit over 4.5 ounces. So it's not a 5 ounce knife. So, you know, does have lightning holes. See if I can get a light on this for you. I'm switching stuff around in the pockets, and boy, it is hard to get a hand in a pocket with a large knife already in it. There we go. So there are the skeletonizing holes, quite a few of them, 6 of them, and a little more in the butt end there on the liner side. Good engagement on the liner. Scalloped in here, very easy access. And it's on bearings, closes very nicely once you get past that detent hump right about there. Pretty smooth. So size-wise, here it is up against the proverbial, perennial, whatever, Rat 1. Choose my adjectives correctly. Exactly the same length. You may not see it from this camera perspective, but looking directly overhead as I can, it is exactly the same length as the Rat 1. So if you know the Rat 1 size, then same size. Here is the Tangram Rubble, also a large knife, and also only about $30 or so. I think that's a division of Kaiser, as I recall, and that is the same size, just a whole different kind of blade there. Wicked reverse curve tanto. Love this blade for the money. Really hard to beat. You get a lot of bang for your buck. So again, as liner locks go, it is solid as a rock. It is nicely centered, perfectly centered. Lots of, I would say, aggressive jimping on the flipper tab. I don't think you're going to slip off of that guy. And a very usable high flat grind on that blade profile. Haven't tried cutting with it. And here's some pre-cut paper. Oh, smooth, very smooth. Let's try that again. Yep. Nice edge from the factory, which is always good. Means we don't need to embellish it any, but you can always improve a factory edge with a little bit of stropping, and you don't recontour the edge, you don't mess it up. So if you're not really good at sharpening, you could be good at stropping. Not hard to do at all. Squarish sort of a handle. Does come in a few different handle colors, I think black. Not sure if they offer a black blade or not, but I will leave you links. To my knowledge, you can only get this directly from Wepe for the moment, although I wouldn't be surprised if places like White Mountain and others will end up carrying it as well. So I do thank David Chen, noted designer, for reaching out and sending me for a review this quite nice and very budgety camper's friend. Camping friend. All be well. Take care. Don't forget to give this vid a like if you would, and subscribe. I'll be back soon.